Hi there, and welcome to TechPlower. It's this time of the year. We are comparing the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 15 Pro cameras. I have the iPhone 15 Pro here, and also the iPhone 12 Pro, recording at the same time. The audio at the moment is coming from my DJI mic. It's using the WinMuff, so hopefully you won't hear the wind noise because it's quite windy outside now. So it will be really interesting to see how the video and still photos have improved from the iPhone 12 Pro to the iPhone 15 Pro. And since this is going to be a quite long video, I've time-coded the video for you in chapters, so you can just jump to any chapter you want. So let's do this. Just before we start, the camera settings on both phones are kept on the default settings for still photos and videos, unless explicitly described otherwise. We'll start with some high dynamic range tests. Here, I'm trying to figure out which of the phones handle dynamic range better. The iPhone 15 Pro does not allow me to turn off the HDR mode, so I keep it on auto, but off on the iPhone 12 Pro. I like how the clouds are represented on the iPhone 15 Pro. They're a little bit overexposed on the iPhone 12 Pro. But on the other hand, the trees and houses are too dark on the iPhone 15 Pro photo, losing some detail that you can clearly see in the iPhone 15 Pro photo, looking at the roof of the White House and more detail in the trees in front of it. Even though the sky is a little bit overexposed on the iPhone 12 Pro photo, I would actually prefer that photo instead of the iPhone 15 Pro one. Turning the HDR on the iPhone 12 Pro and keeping it on auto on the iPhone 15 Pro, you of course get a similar photo from the iPhone 15 Pro, since it is keeping the same settings. But on the iPhone 12 Pro, you don't see much difference in how the clouds are represented, but a little bit darker foreground like the trees and roof of the house. I have to admit, I like the non-HDR photo from the iPhone 12 Pro better than the HDR one. Now, the iPhone 12 Pro loses some of the detail in the background, as the iPhone 15 Pro does. But still, the photo produced by the iPhone 12 Pro is overall better than the one produced by the iPhone 15 Pro. Turning the HDR to auto on the iPhone 12 Pro, which is actually called Smart HDR, and still keeping the iPhone 15 Pro on HDR auto. This seems to darken the foreground of the iPhone 12 Pro even more, losing more detail in the roof and the trees. But the sky and the clouds are consistent with the other photos. I'm actually not really happy how the iPhones are using HDR in this scenario, and the winner in my opinion is the non-HDR photo taken by the iPhone 12 Pro. So after these disappointing HDR photos, let's take a look at some near and far focus shots. Starting with the near focus, pinpointing the focus to the iron pole. Both phones are able to get a great focus on the iron pole and producing beautiful bokeh effect in the background. Looking a little bit closer at these two photos, the iPhone 15 Pro is able to get a better separation between the pole and the background and also producing more blur on the background. In addition, you can also see a little bit more detail in the iron pole, especially if you look closely at the white discoloration of the pole. So here, the iPhone 15 Pro is a clear winner. Let's switch the focus to the background. Here, both phones are actually doing a really good job, both blurring the iron pole well and separating it from the background. Maybe a little bit more blur on the iPhone 15 Pro? Looking at the background here, I almost cannot see any difference between these photos. Both phones are simply doing an awesome job with the focus and the color accuracy. If I have to point out one single detail, I feel like the iPhone 15 Pro shows the sky in a more natural blue color than on the iPhone 12 Pro photo. So we looked at near and far focus. How about really close-up shots? So on the iPhone 15 Pro, we have the macro mode that helps getting good photos of objects really close by. The iPhone 12 Pro does not have this feature, but let's see how they compare. As you can see, there is a clear difference between these photos. where the iPhone 15 Pro provides much better focused photo, whereas the iPhone 12 Pro blurs both the concrete in the foreground and the iron lid in the background. But looking at the detail of the small moss on the concrete, the iPhone 12 Pro shows more detail there than the iPhone 15 Pro. But the iPhone 15 Pro kills it with a detail in the iron lid and much sharper focus and detail in the concrete in the foreground. So it is quite obvious that the macro is doing its job well on the iPhone 15 Pro. We got a glimpse at the bokeh effect these phone cameras can produce, but let's take a little closer look at that feature. Here it gets a little bit tricky though, since the iPhone 15 Pro has an additional 3x zoom that the iPhone 12 Pro does not have. But while taking these photos with the different lenses, I stayed at the same distance from the fire hydrant, so you can clearly see the difference in zoom levels. Starting with the ultra-wide lens on both of the phones. We are not getting much bokeh or blur in the background, as expected with the ultra-wide lenses, but the iPhone 15 Pro is able to keep more natural colors of the fire hydrant and better exposure of the clouds in the background. Switching to the main lens on both phones, you can of course see that the fire hydrant is closer to us now, and the iPhone 12 Pro is actually producing more natural colors in the photo than in the ultra-wide photo. So both phones are actually producing quite similar photos this time around, but neither of them is able to produce much bokeh in the background. Switching to the 2x telephoto lens, we are finally seeing some more bokeh effect in the background, especially in the iPhone 15 Pro photo. We also see a big difference between these photos now. The photo produced by the iPhone 12 Pro is way too overexposed, both in the clouds and on the fire hydrant itself. So here, the iPhone 15 Pro produces more consistent color accuracy and more bokeh effect using the 2x zoom. Switching to the 3x zoom on the iPhone 15 Pro, but keeping the 2x zoom on the iPhone 12 Pro since it doesn't have 3x zoom, you of course see the fire hydrant much closer now on the iPhone 15 Pro photo, and it is still keeping the colors and the exposure really good. You just see a white mess in the clouds in the iPhone 12 Pro photo, while you see some detail in the clouds in the iPhone 15 Pro photo, as well as more detail in the fire hydrant. But we are not getting more blur in the background in the iPhone 15 Pro photo, even though we are zooming a lot closer to the fire hydrant. Since both phones have portrait mode, I was curious to see if that could help in this fire hydrant situation. Let's take a look. I was not able to trigger the portrait mode from the same distance on the iPhone 12 Pro as you can see in this first comparison, so I had to move a little bit closer to take a second photo with the iPhone 12 Pro, but keeping the same photo for the iPhone 15 Pro. The iPhone 12 Pro photo is getting more blur compared to the other fire hydrant photos taken by the iPhone 12 Pro, but it still struggles with the overexposure. The iPhone 15 Pro photo actually just looks really similar to the 3x zoom photo taken previously, so I don't think the portrait mode is helping much in the iPhone 15 Pro in this situation. After all these close-up shots, let's look around and get some beautiful panorama shots in. In this first panorama comparison, both phones produce very similar photos, but now it is the iPhone 12 Pro that produces a little better results if we look at the clouds, that are a little overexposed in the iPhone 15 Pro photo. But the detail and the color accuracy is just on point in both photos, and you can actually see our fire hydrant in the photos. In the second panorama comparison, we have the sun in the clouds in front of us, and both phones are struggling with that. The iPhone 12 Pro has a larger bright spot where the sun is, but the iPhone 15 Pro has a more condensed area where the sun is hiding the clouds and is able to keep a better exposure on the grass in the foreground of the photo. But in the iPhone 15 Pro photo, we get two dots of green lens flare, but only one in the iPhone 12 Pro photo, and these lens flares are really annoying. Despite these double lens flares, I have to give it to the iPhone 15 Pro, since it keeps a better exposure throughout the photo than the iPhone 12 Pro does. How about some selfies, but still using the cameras on the back of the phones? In my opinion, it's not difficult at all to pick a winner here. The iPhone 15 Pro. It simply produces more color accurate and better exposed photo than the one produced by the iPhone 12 Pro. It also blurs the background more and separates me better from the background. But how about if we have the sun behind me? Here, the winner is not as clear as in the other photo. Both phones are struggling with the exposure on myself, but the iPhone 12 Pro photo is a little bit more overexposed than the iPhone 12 Pro photo, especially if you look at the gravel road and the clouds in the background. Switching to the telephoto lens on both phones with 2x zoom, we are able to get some blur in the background on both photos, but much more so on the iPhone 15 Pro photo. Both phones are able to produce equally detailed and focused photos, but the iPhone 15 Pro shows more accurate colors than the iPhone 12 Pro here as well. Switching to the 3x zoom on the iPhone 15 Pro, but of course keeping the iPhone 12 Pro on 2x since it doesn't have the 3x zoom. It's a little bit difficult to frame my face using the 3x zoom, but I'm getting similar color accuracy and detail as I got from the 2x photo. Seems like I'm getting the same amount of blurred background, but it's a little bit difficult to see since so little of the background is visible. Thus, the iPhone 15 Pro beats the iPhone 12 Pro here as well. Since we're trying to get a blurred background, let's try the portrait mode in the same scenario. 1x zoom portrait works well on both phones. Similar color accuracy and exposure, but more blur in the background in the iPhone 15 Pro photo. We get very similar results using the 2x portrait zoom, where we get really similar color accuracy, exposure and detail in both photos. But again, more blur in the background in the iPhone 15 Pro photo. Looking a little bit closer at the colors in the iPhone 15 Pro are a little bit warmer than in the iPhone 12 Pro, and in my opinion, the iPhone 12 Pro is showing more details in the beanie than the iPhone 15 Pro. But since the focus here is the blur of the background and sharpness, the iPhone 15 Pro takes the cake here. Switching to the 3x zoom of the iPhone 15 Pro that the iPhone 12 Pro does not have, we now get more detail in the beanie in the iPhone 15 Pro photo while still keeping the color accuracy and the blur in the background. We've compared a lot of photos taken with the main cameras outside, but let's go inside and take a look at some low light shots. These photos are taken in daytime, with lights in the room turned off, and the only light is coming in at the sides of the window blinds. Using the flash on each of the phones, with night mode turned off, we get a really similar photo from each of the phones. If I can pinpoint something, then the iPhone 15 Pro produces slightly more color accurate photo representing the real life colors better than the iPhone 12 Pro photo. Turning off the flash on both the phones and keeping night mode off, we again get quite similar photos, but this time around the iPhone 12 Pro is able to get a better overall focus, especially if you look at the albums to the upper left of the photo. But again, the iPhone 15 Pro produces more accurate colors. So I would say that here we have a tie. So let's turn night mode on both the phones, but keeping the flash on off. Both phones are doing really well here, but the iPhone 15 Pro still produces more accurate colors and a little bit more detail, especially if you look at the fish on the shelf, it has a little bit sharper detail. So I would say that the iPhone 15 Pro has a slight edge here. Let's switch to some selfies, but still with the back cameras, and first with a bright background behind me, where you see the daylight sneak in on the edges of the blinds. Here I have the flash on auto on both phones, but night mode is turned off. The iPhone 15 Pro decided not to use flash, which the iPhone 12 Pro did, which resulted in a much brighter iPhone 12 Pro photo with more detail than the iPhone 15 Pro photo. Even though the brightness of the iPhone 12 Pro photo is a little bit over the top, it also has a better focus than the iPhone 12 Pro photo. So I would definitely pick the iPhone 12 Pro photo here. Turning the flash off and night mode to auto, the iPhone 12 Pro really struggled to get the focus right, so the whole photo is blurry. But the iPhone 15 Pro photo is now better focused and more evenly lit than without night mode. Turning around so I'm facing the window, now keeping the flash on auto and night mode off. The same thing happens again. The iPhone 12 Pro decides to use flash, but the iPhone 15 Pro does not. In my opinion, the iPhone 12 Pro produces a better photo in this situation. Even though it's a little bit too bright as before, but having a more detailed photo gives the iPhone 12 Pro the edge here. Turning the flash off and night mode on in this situation, the iPhone 15 Pro produces much sharper and color accurate photo than the iPhone 12 Pro. That again struggles with a proper focus when using the night mode here. Let's take the low light to an extreme by placing the cameras on a tripod in a room that has no light. Having the phones on a tripod allows for longer exposure in the night mode setting. Here we see a huge difference and obviously some great improvements in the night mode capabilities of the iPhone 15 Pro. The iPhone 15 Pro was able to use the maximum of 30 second exposure while shooting in the darkness, while I was only able to get 29 seconds on the iPhone 12 Pro for some reason. Even though neither of the photos are good, there is a night and day difference between them, where you can clearly see that we have a red office chair on the iPhone 12 Pro photo, but in the iPhone 12 Pro photo, we can see that we have something bright colored in the photo, but I wouldn't be able to recognize what it is. In the iPhone 15 Pro photo, we even see that there is something on the wall behind the chair, but we don't see anything behind the chair in the iPhone 12 Pro photo. Just for comparison, using the flash on both phones, still on a tripod, we can clearly see the subjects of the photo. The red office chair, an aluminum ladder on the wall, brown door and a white radiator. Both phones actually do a good job capturing these objects in a pitch black room, but still getting relative accurate colors and focus. Since we've been at it for a while, it's getting dark outside, so let's check how the cameras handle some night photography outside. Let's start with both flash and night mode off. I'm surprised how well both phones capture these photos at night without using night mode. But even though these photos look similar at first look, you can see that the iPhone 12 Pro is more grainy in the clouds and the lights in the windows are more overexposed than on the iPhone 15 Pro photo. Turning night mode on both phones, but leaving the flash off, obviously produces a better photo in both cases. We'd get better lit photos with more detail and better handling of bright lights in the windows of the houses. But even though the iPhone 12 Pro is doing a good job in this case, the iPhone 15 Pro is doing an even better job by showing more detail in the clouds and on the wooden poles. You can almost see what's inside the houses through the windows as well. With both flash and night mode on auto, the iPhone 12 Pro takes a similar photo as with the flash off. But the iPhone 15 Pro uses the flash to brighten up the foreground of the photo, giving us more detail in the wooden poles, but keeping the awesome night mode effect in the clouds and in the windows of the houses. Another example where we keep both flash and night mode off gives quite good photos from both phones, but the iPhone 12 Pro struggles more with the orbs around the street lights than the iPhone 15 Pro. Same scenario with flash off, but night mode on, we again get a brighter photo from both phones. But iPhone 12 Pro still struggles more with the streetlights than the iPhone 15 Pro. With both flash and night mode on auto in this scenario, it does not seem to make any difference compared to the previous photos, since there is nothing really close by in the foreground for the flash to light up. I simply had to add this one, because this bench and trash bin are located where almost no streetlights light them up, but still, both are able to use night mode to show us what we are taking a photo of without using the flash. Even though the iPhone 12 Pro does a good job here, the iPhone 15 Pro takes the cake with a much sharper and more color accurate photo. Just two more low-light photos outside with the back cameras. Now on a tripod, on a hill, in pitch black. In this photo, the iPhone 15 Pro only exposed the photo for 8 seconds, while the iPhone 12 Pro did it for 27 seconds. But still, both phones produce awesome photos considering there are no lights on this hill and it's pitch black. I still notice, since the iPhone 12 Pro exposed the photo longer, it provides a little bit brighter and more detailed photo on the ground, but the clouds in the iPhone 15 Pro photo have more contrast than in the iPhone 12 Pro photo. So I would say this one is a tie. The second photo has a little bit more light in the background. The iPhone 15 Pro again only took 8 seconds exposure, while the iPhone 12 Pro exposed the photo for 18 seconds. Here I have to give the win to the iPhone 15 Pro, since it both produces brighter ground and better representation of the clouds than the iPhone 12 Pro. The iPhone 12 Pro also struggles more with the orbs around the lights as before. Let's go back in time and out in the sun again and compare the photos that the front-facing cameras can produce. Let's start with some high dynamic range selfies where we have the HDR off on the iPhone 12 Pro, but since it cannot be turned off on the iPhone 15 Pro, it would just have to be on auto. There is no surprise that the iPhone 15 Pro produces a better photo, especially if you look at the exposure of the clouds, since the iPhone 15 Pro is using HDR while the iPhone 12 Pro is not. The iPhone 12 Pro seems to blur the background a little bit more than the iPhone 15 Pro, that I kind of like. Turning HDR on the iPhone 12 Pro and still HDR auto on the iPhone 15 Pro, we see a drastic difference in the iPhone 12 Pro photo, where the clouds are now better exposed and a little bit evenly lit face, while the iPhone 15 Pro photo is very similar to the previous one. I still think that the iPhone 15 Pro is doing a slightly better job here, providing more detail on me and better exposed clouds. Turning HDR to Smart HDR on the iPhone 12 Pro seems to cause the phone to zoom in a little bit on the photo, but still producing a similar lit photo as when the HDR is on. Now, comparing the clouds between these photos, they're both exposed really well, but still the iPhone 15 Pro provides more detail in the photo. Keeping the settings the same, that is HDR on auto on both, but turning towards the sun, the iPhone 15 Pro produces a more realistic exposure and colors than the iPhone 12 Pro photo. And you can clearly see the missing details here on the straps of my bag in the iPhone 12 Pro photo. Still keeping the same settings, but having the sun in the background, the iPhone 15 Pro does a much better job keeping the exposure on my face, the clouds, and the ground in the background, crowning the iPhone 15 Pro as the front-facing HDR camera winner. Let's go back inside and see how the front-facing cameras on both phones cope with low light situations. Let's start with display flash turned off on both of the phones and with the light from the window facing me. We get a much grainier photo from the iPhone 12 Pro. But even though the iPhone 15 Pro is less grainy, the background is much darker, thus losing much of the detail that we can see in the iPhone 12 Pro photo. We also get a little bit more contrast in my hair in the iPhone 12 Pro photo, and I actually think I would pick the iPhone 12 Pro instead of the iPhone 15 Pro one, because we get more of the details in the iPhone 15 Pro photo. Turning the display flash on both phones, they both manage to light up my face better, but the background is still quite dark on the iPhone 15 Pro photo, and the background also gets more grainier this time around. So again, I would pick the iPhone 12 Pro photo here. Setting the display flash on both phones to auto, both phones decide to use the display flash and produce very similar photos as when the display flash was set to on, with the same conclusion that, in my opinion, the iPhone 12 Pro photo looks better. Having the window behind me with the display flash set to off on both phones, the iPhone 15 Pro destroys the iPhone 12 Pro, where you almost can't see my face in the iPhone 12 Pro photo. I'm not saying that the iPhone 15 Pro photo is good. It just handles the bright background much better than the iPhone 12 Pro. Setting the display flash on auto on both phones. Both phones decide to use the display flash, and this time around the photos are quite comparable. But now I'm getting more detail in the iPhone 15 Pro photo, but a grainier background compared to the iPhone 12 Pro photo. So in this case, since the main subject, which is me, has more detail and sharper focus on the iPhone 15 Pro photo, I would pick that one in this scenario. Turning night mode on both phones shows a drastic difference, especially in the iPhone 12 Pro photo, because now we see my face even though we have a bright background. The iPhone 15 Pro also shows improvements here, where we see less grainy background and better lit face compared to the other photos. So in this case, the choice is simple. The iPhone 15 Pro is better in my opinion. Facing the window again, still with night mode on both phones, we get quite comparable photos from each of the phones, but the iPhone 12 Pro took longer to process it. The iPhone 12 Pro photo is also a little bit too bright for my taste, and also has less detail than the iPhone 15 Pro photo. So in some low light situations, the iPhone 12 Pro produces better photos with the front-facing camera than the iPhone 15 Pro, but in most scenarios, it is the other way around. We've looked at still photos with both back and front-facing cameras of both phones. But how about the videos? Let's take a look at those now, and we'll start with the back cameras for video stabilization test. First, we compare videos in 1080p 30 frames per second. In these shots, both phones are doing really good at stabilizing the videos, and I cannot notice any improvements here in the iPhone 15 Pro over the iPhone 12 Pro. Switching to 1080p 60 frames per second, both phones are again doing a good job in the stabilization, but I think I see a little bit smoother stabilization now in the iPhone 15 Pro video, but it is just slightly better. Now upping the quality to 4K and lowering the frame rate back to 30 frames per second, it seems like the iPhone 15 Pro has a slight edge in smoothing down the stabilization compared to a little more jerky video from the iPhone 12 Pro. Upping the frame rate to 60 frames per second, but keeping it in 4K, it is more obvious now that the iPhone 15 Pro is better at stabilizing the video in 4K. And you can even notice some flickering of focus in the iPhone 12 Pro video that you don't see in the iPhone 15 Pro. I'm a little bit curious to see how the action mode on the iPhone 15 Pro improves the stabilization compared to the iPhone 12 Pro that does not have the action mode feature. So here I'll keep the iPhone 12 Pro at 4K 60 frames per second. But in the action mode, the iPhone 15 Pro automatically switches to the ultra-wide lens, cropping into the sensor, resulting in a video in 2.8K, but keeps the frame rate at 60 frames per second. We get a similar field of view in both shots, but it is obvious when I walk a little bit faster that the action mode is stabilizing the video much better than the iPhone 12 Pro is able to do without the action mode. The iPhone 15 Pro is able to do this without losing too much detail in the video, in my opinion. Now we know how the stabilization is on these phones, but how do they compare in quality? We'll start with 1080p 30 frames per second as we did in the stabilization videos. Both phones are working well here. You see a little bit warmer colors and more blur in the background on the iPhone 15 Pro, but both videos are equally detailed, keeping a sharp focus and cope similarly with the brightness change when pointing the camera up towards the clouds and the sun. Switching to 60 frames per second, but still keeping the same quality. We are seeing similar differences between these videos as we did with the 30 frames per second shot, and both videos are really smooth and don't seem to be dropping any frames. Now let's up the quality to 4K, but only in 30 frames per second. These two are really similar, but in some cases the iPhone 15 Pro is struggling with keeping the focus on the objects in the foreground, where the focus in the iPhone 12 Pro shot stays sharp, but otherwise they are really equal in quality. Upping the frame rate to 60 frames per second, this is where we might see some more fluctuation in exposure in the shots. Same thing happens here with the iPhone 15 Pro. It is struggling a little bit with the focus in some cases on objects in the foreground, and the iPhone 12 Pro is struggling more with the sun, showing more of the sunbeams when the camera is pointed in the same direction as the sun, and the camera flare is more obvious in the iPhone 12 Pro shot as well. Otherwise, both phones produce great videos, and I'm impressed with the smooth white balance changes on both phones. Just for curiosity, I want to see if the lock white balance that is only available on the iPhone 15 Pro makes any difference in this scenario. Comparing these two shots, I don't see any improvement or benefits in the iPhone 15 Pro shot using the lock white balance feature in this scenario. Maybe it is more beneficial in other scenarios. Since the iPhone 15 Pro now offers macro mode when shooting videos, let's see how it compares with the iPhone 12 Pro without the macro functionality. Well, I am not impressed with this functionality. The iPhone 12 Pro did a much better job at showing the moss up close than the poorly focused shot of the iPhone 15 Pro using the macro mode. I don't know why it worked so poorly on the iPhone 15 Pro. Maybe I wasn't close enough to the subject, but at least I wasn't able to get it to work properly. Now let's see how quickly these phones change the focus of the video when the distance to the object changes. Both phones are quite quick adjusting the focus here, and the iPhone 15 Pro blurs the background more when the focus is on my hand, but the iPhone 12 Pro is still quicker at getting a sharp focus at my hand, and then again at the pole when I remove my hand from the shot. So maybe it takes some extra processing power on the iPhone 15 Pro to get this extra blur in the background, thus slowing down the focus speed. So iPhone 12 Pro is surely a winner here in the focus speed. Let's move over to some slow motion video. I'm quite surprised that the iPhone 15 Pro still does not do slow motion in 4K. It has the exact same quality and frame rates as the iPhone 12 Pro. Let's start with 1080p at 120 frames per second. These slow-mo videos are really similar. I almost can't see any difference between these videos regarding the quality or smoothness of the videos. The only difference that I can see is a slight color temperature difference. No improvement here from the iPhone 15 Pro. Let's up the frame rate to 240 frames per second on both phones and see if we can notice any difference between these shots. For some reason, the iPhone 12 Pro only managed to shoot in 210 frames per second, but the iPhone 15 Pro was able to shoot at the full 240 frames per second, which can be clearly seen between the shots since the cars are moving faster in the iPhone 12 Pro shot compared to the iPhone 15 Pro shot. This is, in my opinion, a total failure for the iPhone 12 Pro in this scenario, since it is not able to shoot in the frame rate that it is set to record in. So the iPhone 15 Pro is a clear winner here in the 240 frames per second slow motion test. The video quality is really important when recording video, but in my opinion, equally as important is the audio quality. So let's compare the audio quality between these phones. I will show an audio icon on the right hand side, either at the bottom or at the top, depending from which phone the audio is coming from. Here I'm comparing the audio quality from the internal microphones on both phones. And let's turn around so we get the wind inside the microphones. And we have these beautiful trees here, and we hear a dog barking maybe in the background. Still have the wind. Let's see how much you hear. Hopefully they've improved the audio quality. It's maybe a little bit difficult to hear some difference in the audio quality here due to the wind, but we at least can hear that both phones cope equally as bad with the wind noise. But my feeling is that the audio recorded by the iPhone 15 Pro is of a little bit better quality than the audio recorded by the iPhone 12 Pro. Just for the fun of it, let's compare the same scenario using my DJI mic as the audio source and hear the difference in audio quality compared to the internal microphones of the phones. Now the wind muff on the DJI mic will definitely do its job.
It sits between the iPhone 12 Pro, the iPhone 15 Pro and the DJI mic.
So you can hear the audio difference. You will see it up on the screen. You can of course hear the difference in audio quality and wind noise reduction using my DJI mic with the wind muff on compared to the internal microphones of the iPhones. But that is of course expected when you have a product like the DJI mic that is specifically designed for audio and has the wind muff to minimize wind noise. I just wanted to demonstrate the importance of having an external microphone when recording video with the iPhones. If you want to see some more audio tests between the DJI mic and some other microphones, feel free to check out my comparison video in the card above. The iPhone 15 Pro has a mode called cinematic mode, where it can artificially create more blur in the background where you are not focusing in the shot. Let's compare it with the iPhone 12 Pro that does not have this feature. The iPhone 15 Pro is now able to blur the pieces of the video that are not in focus even more in this mode and keeping the exposure consistent between the different focus points. But the iPhone 12 Pro struggles with the exposure on the wooden pole when I try to manually focus on the trees in the background. This mode also allows you to change the focus subject and the intensity of the blur afterwards if you edit the video, which might come in handy in some situations. Since the iPhone 15 Pro now offers to record video in Apple ProRes in HDR or log format to an external storage, we of course have to try that out. I have a USB stick connected to the iPhone 15 Pro as an external storage. Let's first start with a short video in Apple ProRes HDR. Unfortunately, the recorded video dropped a lot of frames, and after some investigation, it turned out that my USB 3.0 stick only supported write speeds of 90 megabytes per second. But Apple recommends a minimum of 220 megabytes per second for the external storage device. But even though there are a lot of dropped frames in the recording, I'm able to get more detail out of the shot compared to the iPhone 12 Pro shot. Switching to the Apple ProRes log format, still recording to the USB stick, I still have the dropped frames issue, but not as bad as in the HDR mode. You can also see the color profile in this format is really flat, as it is supposed to be, thus giving me much more control over the color grading in the video. And as you can see here, after I've color graded the log footage, it looks really nice compared to the iPhone 12 Pro video, if you don't think of the dropped frames, of course. So we compared a lot of shots taken outside in well-lit environments, but how do the videos compare taken by these two phones in a low-light environment? This is the same room with the same low-light conditions as when I took the still photos. We'll start in 1080p, at 30 frames per second without the flash on both phones. Whoa, what a difference! Apple has obviously improved the low-light video recording on the iPhone 15 Pro, producing much brighter and less grainy video than the iPhone 12 Pro. Let's switch to 4K 30 frames per second and see if we get some drastic difference here as well. Yeah, the difference is almost the same in 4K 30 frames per second, maybe a little less grainier than before in the iPhone 12 Pro video, but still a big difference in the brightness and quality of the video recorded by the iPhone 15 Pro. Let's switch to 60 frames per second that sometimes results in darker videos. Whoa! Which you can obviously see in the iPhone 12 Pro video. It gets really dark and it's difficult to see some of the objects on the shelf. While the iPhone 15 Pro keeps its great brightness and less grainier video as before. Apple has obviously made great improvements in the low light video recording. So how does it look if we use the flash on the phones while recording the videos in these low light situations? If we start in 1080p 30 frames per second with the iPhone 12 Pro flash, the iPhone 12 Pro is able to light up the environment quite well, but the iPhone 15 Pro is still producing a little brighter video but similar quality between them. With the iPhone 15 Pro flash on, we also get a well-lit environment, but I still feel like the iPhone 12 Pro flash produced more close to real-life colors than when using the iPhone 15 Pro flash. Upping the quality to 4K, keeping it in 30 frames per second, we can notice similar difference here as in 1080p. It seems like the iPhone 12 Pro flash is not as harsh as the iPhone 15 Pro flash, because we get more real-life colors when using the iPhone 12 Pro flash. But now to the most exciting part in this scenario. How will the 60 frames per second video look from the iPhone 12 Pro using the flash? There is of course a huge difference in the iPhone 12 Pro, since now we are actually seeing what is on the shelf when we use the flashes for the recording. But similarly as before, the same difference between the videos. That is, I feel like the iPhone 12 Pro flash gives more close to real life colors than when using the iPhone 15 Pro flash. Having a little bit more light in the scene makes a huge difference for both phones, especially for the iPhone 12 Pro in 60 frames per second, where we get much brighter and less grainier video, and we actually see the objects in the shot. So if you're going to shoot with the iPhone 12 Pro in a really low lit environment, I would not use the 60 frames per second option. So we looked at some videos taken in low light inside, but how will these phones handle recording video outside at night? Let's find out. Keep in mind there is no night mode while recording video on either of the phones. In 4K, 30 frames per second, you can see a clear difference between the video recording here. We get much more detail and sharper focus in the iPhone 15 Pro, especially if you look at the windows in the houses and the trees in front of the houses. In the iPhone 12 Pro shot, we even see some dropped frames, so the iPhone 15 Pro is our clear winner in the outside low light video recording. I'm interested to see whether the darkness will affect the stabilization capabilities of these phones. The low light does not seem to affect the stabilization that much, but the video from the iPhone 12 Pro is losing some frames that makes it a little bit choppy, and thus looks more unstable than the video recorded by the iPhone 15 Pro. So we've extensively tested the video capabilities of the back cameras. But we can of course also record video on the front-facing cameras. So let's go back to the daylight and test them out. Starting with a stabilization test in 1080p 30 frames per second. Both phones are able to stabilize the videos quite well and keeping my face in focus the whole time. So in this case, I would say it's a tie. Let's up the quality to 4K, still 30 frames per second. There seems to be no difference in the stabilization when switching to 4K on both of the phones, and both phones are still able to keep the focus on me the whole time. What about if we switch to 60 frames per second? No, there is no difference in the stabilization either when upping the frame rate to 60 frames per second. So in my opinion, the stabilization of the front-facing cameras of both of the phones is equally as good, and no improvements have been made on that on the iPhone 15 Pro. But how is the quality of the videos produced by the front-facing cameras of these two phones? Let's start in 1080p 30 frames per second. Both phones are actually performing quite well in regards to the quality of the videos, with slight differences in color temperature, where we have more warmer tones in the iPhone 15 Pro, but I wouldn't say I can pick a winner here. Let's see if there is more difference in 4K 60 frames per second. I don't see any noticeable quality difference between these shots. This makes me think that there haven't been much improvements in the front-facing cameras in regards to video recording between the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 15 Pro. We now know that there is not much quality difference between the front-facing cameras. But is there a difference in how quickly the front-facing cameras switch the focus when the distance to the subject changes? It doesn't seem like the front-facing cameras have much variable focus, but the iPhone 15 Pro camera has much sharper focus than the iPhone 12 Pro camera, especially if you look at the wooden pole and the trees in the background when my face is not in frame. So I have to give the win to the iPhone 15 Pro here in the focus speed test. The reason I always do an audio test both with the back cameras and the front-facing cameras is that the phone might be using different microphones when recording with the front-facing cameras than when recording with the back cameras.
There is a helicopter in the background. Do you hear it?
I'm not sure.
I have to listen when we look at the videos afterwards. We of course still have some wind. The phones might pick that up in the audio. Now I barely hear the helicopter. Wind is picking up a little bit.
The audio quality difference here is quite similar though, as to when recording with the back cameras. We pick up a lot of wind noise with both phones, but we are getting a slightly better audio quality with the microphones in the iPhone 15 Pro. We've tested the video recording of the front-facing cameras in well-lit environments, but how will they cope in low-light situations? Let's start with 1080p, 30 frames per second. Both phones produce quite bad videos in this scenario, but the iPhone 15 Pro produces a slightly brighter and a little bit more detailed video than the iPhone 12 Pro. Upping the quality to 4K, we get quite similar results as in 1080p, but with slightly less grainy video from both phones. But the iPhone 15 Pro still produces a better result here. Upping the frame rate to 60 frames per second, we see huge difference between these videos now, where the iPhone 12 Pro video is almost totally black, and you can't even see my face in the video. Where on the other hand, in the iPhone 15 Pro video, you get similar brightness as in the previous videos. It gets a little bit better when I have the light from the window behind me, but still the video from the iPhone 12 Pro is way too dark to even recognize who is in the video. So Apple at least upped their game in the low light videos taken with the front-facing cameras as well. Finally, let's go outside and see how the front-facing cameras cope with the limited light during the night. Starting with 1080p 30 frames per second. Here we actually get a brighter video from the iPhone 12 Pro, but a little bit more grainier than the iPhone 15 Pro. But when walking towards the street lights, both videos brighten up, and still with more grainy video from the iPhone 12 Pro. But I'm kind of impressed by the iPhone 12 Pro here. Let's see how they compare in 4K 30 frames per second. Here we get a very similar result as in 1080p. And I think I would pick the iPhone 12 Pro shot here, even though it is a little bit more grainier, but it makes up for it with a brighter video than the iPhone 15 Pro produces. Switching to 60 frames per second, the iPhone 12 Pro caves in and provides worse video than the iPhone 15 Pro, but only slightly worse, which is surprising since it provided such a bad video when recording inside in 60 frames per second. So what are the conclusions of all these comparisons? It is clear that the iPhone 15 Pro has a lot of improvements in low light capabilities, both in still photos and videos, which is really good because that has been a weak point of iPhones in the past. The iPhone 15 Pro also offers more camera features than the iPhone 12 Pro. Action mode to get even more stable videos in shaky situations, Apple ProRes recording to an external storage device in both HDR and log formats, which opens up a lot of opportunities to use the iPhone 15 Pro in more professional settings with greater control over color grading and the style of the video. The audio quality has also been slightly improved, but not up to the point where I would recommend using the audio straight from the phone in a professional setting. Then you should use something like the DJI mic or some other microphone. The macro mode in both still photos and videos did not impress me in the scenarios I tested, especially in video, where the video simply was blurry compared to the non-macro mode video from the iPhone 12 Pro. I was actually quite surprised how well the iPhone 12 Pro stacks up to the iPhone 15 Pro, especially in well-lit environments. The iPhone 12 Pro lacks some of the new fancy features of the iPhone 15 Pro, but the still photos and videos that it can produce are still really comparable to the latest and greatest iPhone 15 Pro. I really hope you liked this video. At least I really liked making it, even though it's a lot of work getting all the footage for the comparisons, putting it all together and review every little detail in these comparisons. If you have any questions regarding the comparison, please don't hesitate to ask me in the comments, and I will try to answer you to the best of my knowledge. And if you like what you see here, please consider subscribing to my channel, because it really helps my channel grow. See you in my next video.